G'day all, Mr. Paladin here. Time for another video log and mailbox, and it's number 10. And as promised, you guys have been wondering where these little guys have been. It's Lewis and it's Clark, and they haven't been on camera for a while. Hey there, Clark. Clark, just so you can tell the difference, they look kind of similar. But Clark, he's this guy. Well, they want to get out. They want to run around. This is... He's getting in my ear. This is Clark here. No, this is Lewis. It's hard to see. I have to see their mask on the front because Clark is darker. Yeah, that's Clark. And Lewis is lighter. But I'm going to let him run loose. But I know you guys were wondering ever since I had the cage. Oh, hey. Ever since I had the cage behind me where they had got to. But I just moved them to a different room because they just needed to be out and about. And I'm going to let them run around the house for right now and get some exercise. So today in this video log, I'm going to be doing a mailbox. We've got several items in the mail. I don't want to give addresses or anything, but I know this one's a piece of art because the artist has told me that it was coming and wanted to know if it was here. But this one in particular, I tweeted about because it's freaking adorable. But I'll do it last. I want to hit up the art package first. See what it is because it's been hanging out a while. I love it when they're easy to open. Oh, I don't even want to touch the front of this. It's on a good material, so I don't want to touch the front of the art. I'm going to do it really safe, like just now that I've taken a peek at it. And what have we got? You guys have seen it before I am. Well, I can kind of see the light through it. I've got to turn it around. Isn't that cool? That's like my outro. Oh man, and that's really glossy. I don't know if you can see the shine off my window right next. Yeah, see? And the shine off my screen. Wow, that's really glossy. That's nice. I love that. That is awesome. That's going up on the wall. Definitely got to do something like that. I don't know. Thank you very much. Who was that from? I've got to double check. That was out of Montreal, Quebec. And I don't know how to pronounce your name. It looks like it's pronounced Moses, but I don't know if it's pronounced Moses because it's like another language. You know how you've got different sayings like Jesus and Jesus, and I don't know the correct way to pronounce it. It's Moises, so I think it's Moses or Moises, so I'm sorry if I'm pronouncing your name wrong, but that is freaking awesome. I love it. Man, that's put me in a good mood now. I like stuff like that. I like seeing all different arts and artists from around the place doing the stuff. It's just so encouraging. I like seeing people who have spent their time and effort into doing it, and then you see the rewards of it. Because you know all the great artists out there, right? They didn't wake up on Monday morning and go, "Gee, today I'm going to paint, you know, the Mona Lisa," or whatever, you know. But the Mona Lisa was famous for a bunch of other reasons, but still, Mona Lisa, famous painting, whatever. You know, they didn't just wake up and do it. In fact, I read this thing recently where, like, Michelangelo destroyed some of his early sketches of the works that he did, so people didn't know all the process that went into making his masterpieces. It's like crazy. This next letter comes from Max. Max from Painter, VA. Okay, so let's see what Max has to say. Okay, and this says, "Dear Mr. Paladin, concerning the t-shirt, your t-shirt design is simply epic." I'm wearing one now. Hold on, let me stand up. This was good. This was made by an artist online that I've retweeted on Twitter. If you go to the links in my videos in the video description, you'll see the store, you'll see the artist's name and how to get in touch with them. But yeah, I mean, I didn't design this myself. I mean, I had this commissioned, and it's awesome. I have some ideas for it though. Okay. Could there be a gray version? And do you remember how your Facebook picture was something like this, Mr. P, or something resembling that? Could that be on the back of the shirt? You see, I've changed up the branding on the website recently, and I've changed the way the Mr. P stuff looks now. So I might flash it up in a corner what the Mr. P logo looks like as far as branding's concerned. But as far as color of the shirt's concerned, like this stuff has to kind of be on white. But if you want it on any color, the store can do it. But it has to be put on a white vinyl kind of thing before it can be printed on. But yeah, it's doable. They can quote you out that stuff. If any of the art that we have you want on there, or even if you commission your own art and like get in touch with the store, she'll make it happen somehow. At least give you a quote for it. Okay, concerning my videos, they're great. I love them. Just one thing, please, please, please make more mailbox videos. Unless, of course, you just don't get enough. You know what? You guys could be sending me more mail. I've got the mailbox open. Go ahead and send them in. Write me up something. Send me something from around where you are at. I don't care if it's anything in particular. Just take a picture. Send me pictures. I like pictures. I'm sounding old now, aren't I? Old folks always like seeing pictures from the rest of the family. Good work. Can't wait for more. May God bless you. Little Grim Reaps, and Little Grim Reaps also sent me a picture over here. Hold on, let me make sure there's nothing on the back, because sometimes they write on the back of the letters, but there was nothing on the back of that one. But we do have this Little Grim Reaps with the stylized wording. I always like when the P is done like the knife. That's kind of cool. And we got Little Grim Reaps. Oh no, looks like Little Grim Reaps is a pyro main. And we're facing down each other. Fortunately, I do have my ambassador there, and it's not a spicicle. It is my Australian knife, so I do stand a chance. Awesome. I like it. It's cool. Let me pin it up. Okay, now for the third letter today. And this one was adorable. It was from Isabella, and Isabella is in California. I haven't been to California. I'd like to visit California sometime. I want to get over that direction. Looks like there's some art in here as well. Okay, and from Isabella, we've got this piece of art. It's like, what would you do? And there's a health pack type dealio. What would you do? It's probably related to, I did a video a while back, what would you do for a Delonka bar? I'm always pronouncing that wrong, because I know it's meant to be like the Russian word for chocolate, and I don't know how to say that, but I'd say it like an Australian would, so that's what you get. But I've still got that spray, actually. I've still got that spray, and I might do another video like that. There's actually a couple fun videos I want to do. Let me pull up the list of fun videos that I've got in the queue so you guys know what's
So
up.
just today I was actually playing a couple of King of the Hill games, and I started out playing King of the Hill with a Cloak and Dagger because somebody had asked, for some more Cloak and Dagger footage, and I have other people asking for maps that aren't Payload, because I do favor Payload, because when you play Payload, the team kind of gets directed towards the objective, but some of the other game modes, your team doesn't even try and do the objective, so it becomes really deathmatchy, and deathmatchy isn't really where the spy's at. So I played a little bit of King of the Hill in the way I kind of play it, and I'll be getting some more footage of that. But like back to what would you do? I even thought a while back about doing a series like What Would Mr. P Do, right? And give you kind of the setup that I'm in as a spy, and then stop it, and then ask you to think, hey, what would you do in this situation? And then actually show you what I did in the situation, and see if it kind of bumps out to be the same thing. See if you came up with the same idea that I was thinking of doing, or maybe you guys came up with something that I didn't think about. It might have been better if I had done it your way. Who knows? So that was a video idea sometime, but I've got a little list. See, I keep lists. I write stuff down. My memory's not that good. So I wanted to have a look at what the average gamer is. We have a lot of preconceived notions about what we think the average gamer is, the type of people we're expecting to find online and who they actually are. Who is the average gamer these days? I also wanted to do WM1 Pyros. People have trouble with WM1 Pyros, so I wanted to fully go full WM1 and see what happens. Just goof around with it. I wanted to take another look at Paladins. They have recently introduced legendary cards and a couple of other patches. Some of it may or may not be good for the game. I don't know if the game's going in a direction I like, but I want to see these changes. I was going to make a few funny kind of Overwatch TF2 crossover concept ideas with the characters. I'm not going to hint any more on that. I want to do a video about making Sun on a Stick useful. Yeah, Sun on a Stick. Why? Why is it like that? People keep talking about crutch weapons, like we did in the last video talking about the Dead Ringer. What about Sun on a Stick? There's several items out there that are like Sun on a Stick that are pretty much useless to the point of you don't pick them. I wanted to do a video like I recently did a Matador type video. I wanted to do the same kind of thing for the stair stab. Just the common stabs. I don't mind. There's some super tricky trick stabs out there, but for the most occasions, you don't bother using them, especially not in quick play environments because people can't be. You can't expect a lot of people to react certain ways to make the other stabs work. I want to real soon, and it might be the next one, is I want to do a video about your mouse settings and about how. People ask me, Mr. Paladin, what are your mouse settings? Because I think they want to try and emulate my mouse settings. But if I just give you the straight information about what my mouse is, what its DPI settings is, and what my settings are in game, that's not going to be useful to you. So instead, I want to give you a video that no matter what your hardware is, this is the settings you might consider using for a first-person shooter game, and that'll probably be the next video. But anyway, this is a list of my videos. I got down to about there, and I don't know if that's good enough resolution for you to actually see what the other ones are. So we'll keep those under wraps. Just suffice it to say, I'm not going anywhere. I've got lots of ideas. I got lots of different games to play, lots of stuff to do, and there's one that I just thought about that I need to add to the list because I've been meaning to do it, but I have not. It's about the game Road Redemption that I have not looked at in a little bit. We've also got the Warhammer game that I haven't had a look at in a little bit. There's so much stuff I want to do. So anyway, thank you so much for the art. Thank you so much for the letters. I love getting them. I love getting stuff from around your area, especially if you're international. I know shipping is a lot with the opening of the store. We've been shipping cups and mugs and shirts and mouse pads all over the place, so I know it can be expensive. But hey, if you just want to pen up or pencil up or even crayon up a letter to me, I would greatly appreciate it. So anyway, thanks for watching. I hope this helps you in your future endeavors. Hope to catch you in game.
Non più tra i farfalloni amoroso, notte giorno d'intorno girando, delle belle turbando al riposo, ma ci sento un cino d'amor. Delle belle turbando al riposo, ma ci sento un cino d'amor.